Dear students, welcome you all. In the last class, we have discussed about the various parameters which affects the polymer quality, which we are going to have it for filament production. And also we have discussed in detail about the glass transition temperature and its importance for these man-made fibers. Okay, this is what we have discussed in the previous class. Hope you understand the concept. Okay, so today's class, we are going to start with this solution spinning. So that means in our earlier discussions we have discussed about making the continuous length of yarns with the help of polymer, which is nothing but a spinning process where we are converting the polymer into a continuous length of yarns. That is called a spinning process. In the process of doing this, where we have two different spinning techniques are available. One is melt spinning technique and second one is solution spinning technique. Now in this class, we are going to discuss about how to produce the continuous length of yarns from the polymer using the solution spinning technology. This is what we are going to discuss in this today's class. So, the main objective of today's topic is to impart knowledge in spinning of man-made fibers through this solution spinning technology. And at the end of this presentation, you are going to get an outcome of to understand, or you are able to understand how to produce the filaments using solution spinning, what are the different elements that are present in solution spinning, and how the filament is produced in this solution spinning process. This is what the outcome you are going to get at the end of this presentation. Okay, so let us move on to the concept of solution spinning technology. Okay, now if you look at the spinning process, what do you think the raw material is? Obviously the raw material is a polymer. Okay, so after getting the raw material, what we have to do, we have to convert into fiber. So that must be involved, where first we have to convert the polymer into liquid or semi-liquid state. So it is done either by being dissolved a polymer in a solvent, either by dissolving the polymer in a solvent, or by heating the polymer until its melting point. I told you already what is a melting point. We are taking the polymer and we are start heating the polymer at one point of temperature where the polymer started melting. That is called as melting temperature. So here, after taking the polymer, so before going for production of continuous length of yarn, we have to convert this polymer into liquid state by dissolving in a suitable solvent, or semi-liquid state by heating the polymer until its molten temperature. So this process, why we are doing this process? So this process frees the long molecules from close association with one another, allowing them to move independently. By doing like this, what will happen is, whatever the molecules which are there earlier in a close association, that starts move independently. So which is very much favorable for production of continuous filament of yarns. Okay, now here you can see, this is the entire spinning process through, that is filament production through solution spinning, where the brown color you can see, this is a polymer, and through the polymer what we are doing before taking to the solution spinning, we are converting that in the form of a solution. Here the brown color indicates the polymer solution. So the solid polymer we are converting into its liquid state, and then we are passing through the pump, then through filter, and we are getting continuous length of yarns. So later we have few post-spinning operations which we have already discussed in the last class. Then finally we are getting continuous length of yarn and then winding onto bobbins. So this is about the solution spinning. And now you can see here, so this is about the melt spinning concept. That means here we are taking the polymer chips, where you can see the yellow color is nothing but the polymer chips. In the hopper we are feeding the polymer chips, Now what we are doing, initially the polymer chips are in its solid state. What we are doing here, by heating the polymer chips, we are converting into its semi-solid state, which is nothing but molten state. That molten state of polymer, we are passing through different elements in a melt spinning line, and finally we are producing continuous length of yarns. Okay, here in this spinning, the spinneret plays a very very important role. Depending upon the type of spinneret we are using and cross section of spinneret we are using, where the final cross section of filament, it depends. Now you can see here there are holes are there in a spinneret through which the continuous length of yarns are coming through. It's just like a shower which is used in a household applications. Okay. Coming to this solution spinning. Today's topic is solution spinning only. In solution spinning, so what we are doing in that, you just understand this term solution spinning. So spinning is nothing but, already you know, so producing continuous length of filaments, that is called as spinning. Now that spinning we are doing with the help of solution. Here solution which is meant for polymer solution. Solution which is nothing but polymer solution. So here what we are doing is, we are taking a polymer, think that this is a polymer, and we are dissolving in a suitable solvent. The solvent depends upon, the selection of solvent depends upon the type of polymer we are taking. Say for example, if you take sugar as a polymer and solvent as a water, if you start adding sugar into water, what will happen? Where sugar start dissolving in the water, so thereby it results in a sugar solution. Okay, understand. In the same way, in the process of making continuous length of yarn, here we are taking a polymer. That polymer we are dissolving in a suitable solvent. Understand? After dissolving in a suitable solvent, where we have to go for spinning process. Okay, the two main important things you need to understand, a spinning process which involves a coagulation bath which containing a non-solvent. That means, here you can see the pink color is nothing but the polymer solution. Pink is nothing but the polymer solution. So we have prepared the polymer solution separately. That polymer solution we are taking here, that we are passing through different elements. Now you can see the spinneret is there. From the spinneret, where continuous filament of yarns are getting. Here you have to understand, there is a bath called coagulation bath. There we are taking a non-solvent. So what will happen is, after the spinneret itself, we are placing in this coagulation bath. Whenever the filaments that are coming out, immediately it is subjected in the coagulation solution. Now what will happen is, the solvent which we have used to dissolve the polymer, it gets precipitated, and then where the filament, continuous filaments are coming out. So this type of spinning we call it as, under solution spinning only, we call it as wet spinning. Why? Because the removal of solvent from the polymer solution, we are doing it in a wet state. Now you may have a question, why to remove the solvent? Is it right? So here you just go back to the beginning of the process. How we are preparing the polymer solution here? We are taking polymer, we are dissolving in a solvent. Say for example, you are taking polyacrylonitrile as a polymer. You are dissolving in dimethyl formaldehyde as a solvent. Now, so in the beginning, for our convenience, to prepare the polymer solution, we have selected a suitable solvent. Once the filament is produced, do you think the solvent present is still required for us? No, obviously no. Why? Because if the solvent is present in the filament, in the later stages, again it gives some kind of difficulties. That's why here we are removing the solvent in the presence of wet condition. That's why this spinning is called as wet spinning. Now, the second one is nothing but, so once after preparing the polymer solution, that is dissolving polymer in a solvent, okay, so we are taking to a spinning process. There, once the filaments are produced, we are removing the solvent in the form of or by passing heated gases. Now you can see in this image where you can see the polymer solution which is prepared, and the polymer solution is pumped to metering pump, then through spinneret. So you can see from the spinneret the filament, continuous length of answer coming out. Now you try to observe the difference between this wet spinning and dry spinning. In dry spinning, do you found any coagulation bath here? Do you found any coagulation bath in this dry spinning? No. Instead of coagulation bath, what we are having here, where we are passing warm air or heated gases. That aromas you can see, those are nothing but the heated gases. Why we are passing heated gases here? To remove the solvent which is there in the filaments. Why? Because already solvent is there in a polymer solution. That solvent we are removing here with the help of heated gases. But here the important condition is we are removing the solvent, that is fine, with the help of heated gases. Again there is a question, what should be the temperature of heated gases? What should be the temperature of heated gases? If you look at the temperature, obviously the temperature should be higher than the boiling point of a solvent which we are using to dissolve the polymer. Suppose, for example, if you are using water as a solvent, what is the boiling point of water? It is 100 degrees Celsius. It is 100 degrees Celsius. So what we have to do, whatever the heated gases we are passing, the temperature of heated gases should be higher than the boiling point of water. That means maybe 110 or 120 degrees Celsius heated gases we can pass. This is called as dry spinning. I hope you understand why this solution spinning, again it has categorized into wet spinning and dry spinning. Why? Because in wet spinning, where the solvent removal is taking place in the presence of moist condition, that is in the coagulation bath. In case of dry spinning, where the presence of the removal of solvent, it is taking place in the dry condition. This is the basic difference between wet spinning and dry spinning. Now we have a modification in this solution spinning, where wet and dry spinnings, these two spinnings were combined, and they have introduced the another spinning technique which is called as dry jet wet spinning technique. Dry jet wet spinning technique, this is the one. Now you can see, if you compare the differences between these three images, so what kind of differences you are observing? So do you think, the first, if you take wet spinning, do you think the spinneret is placed inside the coagulation bath? First, if you observe here carefully, so whether the spinneret is placed inside the coagulation bath? No, it is just above the coagulation bath. Now what is the second one? Do you think, are we passing any heated gases here, just like dry spinning? No, nothing like that. There is no heated gases. Now if you see here, if you observe here, the spinneret is just placed above the coagulation bath. So from the spinneret the filaments are coming out, then maybe few centimeter gap is there. That gap is maintained. After that, the filaments are subjected in a coagulation bath. So this kind of modification of the wet and dry spinning together will lead to lot of structural changes in a filament. So mostly the aramid fibers, very high tenacity fibers, are produced through this dry jet wet spinning techniques. As you already know, we have melt spinning is a to produce continuous filament of yarns, and we have solution spinning. Just now I explained you what is solution spinning and how it is divided into wet spinning and dry spinning. Now before going in detail about wet spinning and dry spinning, we should have some fundamental knowledge about in what way this solution spinning is different from melt spinning. In what way this solution spinning is different from melt spinning. Okay, if you look at the differences, the solution spinning is similar to melt spinning. Okay, so with the only difference that the melting point of a polymer is depressed to below the room temperature by adding a solvent. Now, you have to understand this point. It's very, very important for you to understand the functional, the concept, what makes the solution spinning different from melt spinning technique. This is the reason. So, in melt spinning, we discussed in our earlier classes, what we are doing here. So, we are taking the polymer, we are trying to heat, we are trying to give the heat to the polymer. What will happen after some time at one point of temperature, this polymer starts melting. Now, whatever the molten solution we are getting, that molten solution we are taking to for production of continuous length of ends. But here in solution spinning, are we doing any heating for the polymer to melt in the polymer to dissolve in the solvent? Obviously, no. In the room temperature itself, simply we are taking a bath and we are adding a solvent and later we are adding this polymer. And slowly if you dissolve, if you just start stirring the solvent, the polymer in a solvent, just like if you stir, after adding sugar in a water, if you started stirring, what will happen? After some time, the sugar will dissolve in water. In the same way, the room temperature itself, we are dissolving the polymer in a solvent. That is a great advantage with this solution spinning process. However, the solvent has to be removed. Just now we have discussed. Whatever the solvent we are using in the beginning to make the polymer solution, so that is helpful only up to that level. That means once the filament has produced, we have to remove the solvent from the filament. Otherwise, what will happen? What I told you, where these solvent which is present, that will give some difficulties at the time of processing. So that's why we have to remove the solvent from the filament soon after the continuous length of yarns are produced. Okay, either that's removal, how, in what way we are doing, either through coagulation or evaporation to allow solidification. Okay, so therefore solution spinning involves not only heat transfer similar to melt spinning, but also one way or two way mass transfer unlike melt spinning. So that means in case of melt spinning, only one way heat transfer is taking place. So whereas in case of solution spinning, where we have one way and two way mass transfer also, that is taking place along with the heat transfer. Understand? Now you can see there's a kind of differences. The first one is melt spinning and the second one is, that is dry spinning only. You can see here in case of melt spinning, where after production of continuous length of yarns, where we are passing some cool air to just make the filament solidify, that's it. So whereas in case of dry spinning, what we are doing here, so after taking polymer solution and we are feeding and then to spinner it, continuous length of yarns are coming. Now you can see in the side, we are passing heated gases or warm air to evaporate the solvent which is present in the filaments. Understand? So in this way, this solution spinning is different from the melt spinning process. Okay, now there is a question. So already melt spinning is there, which is advantages, then obviously advantages than solution spinning. Why? Because in melt spinning there is no such removal of solvent, so one process has been completely eliminated. So even though the melt spinning process is more success and more advantageous, still we are going for solution spinning. What could be the reason? So this is very, very important. And if I answer this, if I tell you this, so really you will appreciate the method of making continuous filament of yarns using this solution spinning. Now, you have to understand first melt spinning. What we are doing, what I told you already, we are taking polymer, we are heating the polymer. At one temperature, the polymer is melting. Now, we are getting the molten solution. Do you think for all the polymers, after melting, the same properties will retain in the retain with the polymer. Whatever the properties it has got in the solid state, do you think the same properties are there at its molten temperature or molten state? That is a big question mark. So we have different type and number of polymers like polyester, nylon, acrylic, mod acrylic, polypropylene, polyethylene. Likewise, we have n number of polymers are there. Okay, so it is not possible for all the polymers to maintain its properties same in solid state as well as in its molten state. Say for example, if you take polyester, so polyester is a polymer, is a fiber or filament widely used melt spinning is preferred to produce polyester filaments. Why? Because if you take polyester polymer, if you heat it and it is getting melted, now if you just check the properties at its molten state, so what will happen? So where there is no change in the properties from solid state to molten state, so obviously it is convenient to produce through melt spinning process, is it right? Melt spinning process. But when it comes to, say for example, acrylic fiber, if you take the polymer to make acrylic fiber is polyacrylonitrile. If you take the polyacrylonitrile polymer and if you start heating it, obviously at one point like above 300 degrees Celsius or 325, what will happen? This polyacrylonitrile will go to its molten state, but the properties will be deteriorated. We cannot expect the same properties of the polymer at its solid state, where the polymer is going to be degraded. So if you take that and if you produce filaments, do you think the filament is having all such properties, all such good properties required for the end use application? Obviously no. That is the reason this solution spinning is introduced, where the solution spinning is introduced where the polymers which will degrade at its melting temperature, those polymers are subjected to this solution spinning. For example, acrylics, mod acrylics, etc. Understand? So this is what the situation where we can go for solution spinning. And also one more thing, the solution spinning is also recommended for situations when high performance fibers have to be spun. In our earlier discussions, I told you, if you take dry jet wet spinning, where because of its design of the spinning machinery, where it is possible to produce high performance in the fibers. And when entanglement density of spinning liquid is required to be regulated to obtain structures that can be drawn to very high draw ratios. Suppose if you want to maintain high draw ratios, that means draw ratio is nothing but, say for example, this is the filament which is having 5 cm length. Okay, now what you are doing, you are extending up to 15 cm. Now 1:3 will be the draw ratio. That means 3 times you are stretching the filaments. So because of stretching, what will happen? What will happen if you stretch the filament? Where orientation will take place. So if you want to go for very high draw ratios, that time also the solution spinning is. Okay, now let us see the classification. As I already discussed from the beginning of the class itself, this solution spinning has been classified into dry spinning and wet spinning. And we have another classification, which is a combination of dry spinning and wet spinning, which is nothing but dry jet wet spinning. Okay, so now we will discuss in detail about what is this dry spinning and how the instrument or how the machinery looks like, and what are the different elements in this dry spinning line, and what are the different functions of each and every element, and how the filament is coming out. Okay, now if you look at this dry spinning process, if you look at this diagram of dry spinning process, where So I'll just explain you this diagram. I mean, both are similar only. Now you can see this is the polymer solution. So what is the polymer solution? So we are taking the polymer, say for example, this is the bowl. So this is the solvent we have taken. This is the solvent, say for example, this is dimethyl formaldehyde is a solvent, and we are adding a polymer. This polymer is nothing but what we can take here for the time. For example, we have taken polyacrylonitrile as a polymer. Now what will happen after adding this polymer in this solvent? We are mixing it thoroughly. So after some time, what will happen is this polymer will dissolve in this solvent. This polymer will dissolve in this solvent, and finally it looks like this. Now what we are doing is we are taking this polymer and we are just feeding here. We are just taking in the melt spinning line, sorry, solution spinning line. Now this is a solvent. Now what we are doing here is, if you carefully observe the different elements here, this is a hopper where we are feeding the solvent material, and this is the spinning pump, or we can also call it as metering pump. What it will do is, it is going to send whatever the polymer solution is there evenly to the next process or next element. Now this is an important element, which is nothing but the spinneret, So I told you already how this spinneret looks like, Now you can see, so like it will be like this circular, and where you can see these are all the holes. Now what will happen if you pass this polymer solution at some pressure? What will happen is where the filaments will come out from these holes at like this. Filaments will come out from these holes in the whatever the holes which are there in a spinneret. Okay, now you can see these are all the filaments which are coming through the holes which are there in the spinneret. This is called a spinneret. Depending upon the cross section of holes in the spinneret, suppose if the spinneret hole is having this circular cross section, obviously you will get the circular cross section in the filaments. Suppose if the spinneret hole is having hollow, say for example like this, this is the hollow portion. Okay, now you will get the hollow cross section in the filaments. Suppose if the spinneret cross section is like this, now you will get the same kind of cross section with the filaments. Now this is the spinneret. Now this is the space, this is the place where we are passing the heated gases. Why we are passing heated gases, we will discuss. Now you can see this is the exit for the heated gases. Now we are collecting all the filaments. These two are nothing but the draw rollers, so which will impart stretch in the filaments. Afterwards it is winded onto a bobbin here. Understand? So these are all the different elements. Again I'm repeating. So here we have an initial element called hopper, and in the hopper or in the feeding tank we are feeding this polymer solution, whatever the polymer solution we are getting here, we are feeding here. And we have an element called spinning pump or gear pump, which will evenly distribute the polymer solution to the spinneret. Now you can see, like it is a gearing pump, I told you it is also called as gearing pump. So whenever these two rollers rotate at opposite directions, so whatever the gap which is created, through this gap evenly the polymer solution is fed to the spinneret. Why? Because if there is no uniformity in the feeding of polymer solution to the spinneret, obviously what will happen is where we cannot maintain the uniformity in the produced filaments. Now afterwards we have the spinneret. I told you how the spinneret looks like. This is these are all the holes in the spinneret, and we are getting the filaments from the spinneret like this. Just like the shower, you just assume a shower And if you just on the shower, what will happen? The water will come out, na? The same way here also, the same way here also, the filaments will come out from the spinneret. Okay, now here we have a draw rollers which will run at one. There is a differences in the surface speeds of the rollers, so that some stretching or pulling is created. Then it is winding onto a bobbin. So these are all the different elements in the dry spinning process. Now here also you can see the same representation. This is the input for polymer solution. This is a gearing pump. This is a spinneret, and now you can see continuous filaments are coming out. Here you can see these are the filaments. Here this is the input for gas feeding, and then this is the yarn, and it is finally winding onto bobbins here. Okay, now if you look at the working position, working of the dry spinning line. Now soon after, first initially we have to do this, like preparation of polymer solution. This is very, very important process. So here we have to carefully select what is that polymer and what is that solvent we are using. And we cannot use the same solvent for all the polymers. So the polymer, depending upon the type of polymer we are choosing, we have to select the solvent. Understand? Say for example, here what polymer we have taken, for example, polyacrylonitrile. This is the polymer, polyacrylonitrile. So this polymer, dimethyl formaldehyde is a suitable solvent. That means, so in this dimethyl formaldehyde, the polyacrylonitrile polymer, it will dissolve completely. So after that, we will be getting the polymer solution like this, uniform polymer solution. And we, okay, and after getting this polymer solution, we are taking to the dry spinning line and we are feeding. Okay, afterwards, this solution in the sense, it won't be like a water. We are maintaining the viscosity. What do you mean by viscosity here? It is the resistance to flow of a fluids. So it is not like a water. It's like something like an oil, and much more than that. Okay, viscosity is more than that. Now, after taking this polymer solution here, where we are feeding through this gearing pump at some pressure. With some pressure, high pressure, we are feeding this polymer solution into the gearing pump, and through the gearing pump, it will come to the spinneret, or it will reach to the spinneret. And since the spinneret is having fine holes here, what will happen? Where the polymer solution, obviously, it will force through the holes which are there in the spinneret. Now, already I told you in the last slide itself. So here we are using this solvent. Here we are using this solvent. Why we are using the solvent here? To dissolve the polymer. So with this, the solvent function is fulfilled. Now, soon after the production of continuous length of yarns, we don't need the presence of solvent here. So what we are doing? We are passing heated gases. Now here, what is the condition of heated gases here? The temperature. Temperature of heated gases. The temperature of heated gases should be maintained more than or higher than the boiling point of a polymer. For this dimethyl formaldehyde, the boiling point is 65 degrees Celsius. That means if you pass the heated gases, maybe at 80 or 85 degrees Celsius, which is enough to remove the solvent or to evaporate the solvent which is there with the filaments. Now you can see, these are all the small dots you can see. These are all the evaporations. Okay, now already you know, say for example, if you take water, if you start boil the water, and obviously evaporations will come. If you cool the evaporations, what will you will get? Again, you will get the water. The same way, so after evaporating, we are collecting all the solvent, evaporations, and we are making it cool. So obviously what we'll get here, we will get in the recovery of solvent. Whatever the solvent we are using, so most of the solvent we are getting recovery here. So afterwards, the filaments are taken and it is drawn in between two draw rollers, depending upon the draw ratio which is required, and then it is winding onto bobbins. So likewise, in dry spinning, the continuous filament of yarns are produced. Continuous filament of yarns are produced. And when you take the melt spinning process, so this many, like we are not passing any heated gases, simply we are passing the cool air, so that solidification is taking place very fast when compared to this dry spinning process. So that is one of the drawback, we can say, when compared with this melt spinning line. Okay, hope you understand this dry spinning concept. Now this, as I told you already, dry spinning is faster than solidification by compared to wet spinning process, like there this coagulation and all it is involved. Now these differences are more clearly understood in terms of rate controlling process which is involved in these methods. Rate controlling, that may be heat or that may be mass transfer. So the heat transfer which will take place in case of melt spinning, and in case of dry spinning where heat transfer along with one way mass transfer, and in case of wet spinning heat transfer and two way mass transfers. So likewise, where the rate controlling is there in melt, dry spinning. Okay, now let us discuss about this wet spinning process. Okay, already I have given you some brief about what is the wet spinning and how the filament is produced in wet spinning process. Okay, here now this is the representation of wet spinning process. Now we will discuss in detail about what is this wet spinning and how the filament is produced. Okay, let us go into this diagram. Okay, so this is wet spinning, the schematic representation of wet spinning process. Okay, now you can see, so as I told you in the earlier slides, so for either it may be dry spinning or wet spinning, so what we have to do, we have to take the solvent. This is nothing but the solvent, depending upon the type of polymer we are taking for preparing the polymer solutions, we have to take the solvent and we have to add the polymer. We have to add the polymer. Okay, now what will happen? What will happen after adding the polymer? If you started stirring, now finally this polymer will gets melted. Sorry, it gets dissolved in the solvent. Finally, we'll be getting like this, which is nothing but the polymer solution. Okay, now we got polymer solution with us, which is also called as dope. This polymer solution, we can also call it as dope, don't get confused. Now what we are doing is we are taking the dope and we are just feeding to the metering pump. In case of dry spinning also the metering pump is same, metering pump or gearing pump, are both are similar only. Then it is subjected to filter. So in filter, whatever the dust particles, if at all any impurities are there, that is getting filtered out. Now you can see the parts of the melt spinning, like here the provision for adding dope, metering pump, filter, and then you can see what is this. This is nothing but the spinneret. Okay, now here we have an additional element called, what it is? It is nothing but coagulation bath or spinning bath. Okay, coagulation bath or spinning bath. Now you can see the spinneret which is placed inside the coagulation bath. Then we have a guide roller and then we have drawing rollers. Understand, these are the different elements in this wet spinning line. Now if you look at how these filaments are produced in this wet spinning process. Now you can see, as usual, dry spinning, we are preparing the polymer solution here. We are feeding through this metering pump. The solution, it is coming like this. And then it is getting filtered out. So the impurities are getting filtered out. And then the polymer solution, which is fed to the spinneret, which is placed inside the coagulation bath, which is placed inside the coagulation bath at some pressure. We are feeding at some pressure. Say for example, if you take a shower and if you just pour some water without any pressure, what will happen? Do you think the water will come out at a force from the nozzles of the shower? No, it will come like slowly and like that. So here we are feeding the polymer solution at some pressure, so that you can see here the continuous filaments are coming out. Now you have to observe one thing. So the spinneret, entire spinneret, we are placing inside the coagulation bath. This is the coagulation bath. We are taking a non-solvent here. So depending upon the type of fiber we are producing, accordingly we'll be selecting the different chemicals in this coagulation bath. Now what will happen here is, so the main purpose of coagulation bath, placing coagulation bath here, is to remove or to precipitate the solvent which is present in these filaments. So here we have added now already the solvent, whatever the solvent which is there, it is still with the polymer, still with the filament. Now soon after the filaments that is coming out, and when it is traveled from here to here, what will happen is the solvent is getting precipitated. The solvent is getting precipitated. Understand? The solvent is getting precipitated. So now the filament is free from the solvent, then it is winded onto these gaudet rollers. We can also call it as draw rollers. Depending upon the draw ratio, we are maintaining the speeds. Then it is winding onto bobbins. Okay, so this is how this wet spinning process works, how it is producing this continuous length of yarns. So here we are placing the coagulation bath. The filament has to drawn through the coagulation bath and it has to taken out. So that's why if you look at the spinning speeds, obviously the wet spinning process runs at slower speeds when compared to dry spinning process. Why? Because here heat transfer has to take place, and the two-way mass transfer also it has to take place. So this makes an advantage of making these staple fibers. So in case of dry spinning, the spinning speeds are more, so that it is preferred to produce continuous length of yarns. Since here the spinning speeds are less, that is 350 or 400 meters per minute, where soon after getting the filaments, what we can do is we can cut into required lengths comfortably. Okay, this is about the wet spinning process. Hope you understand this wet spinning process. Now you can see here the combination of fibers, that is polymers, and then suitable solvents. This is a fiber, and this is a suitable solvent, and then what should be added in the coagulation bath, what type of chemicals we need to add. You can see the chemicals are not same here. This is different and this is different and this is different. Now if you look at the viscose rayon fibers, if you are making viscose rayon through this solution spinning, that is wet spinning process, where the solvent should be of alkane water, that is alkaline water, it is, the polymer is dissolved, and the coagulation bath, it consists of dilute sulfuric acid, sodium sulfate and zinc sulfate. Okay, and then if you want to produce polyvinyl alcohol fiber through this wet spinning process, where initially the polymer has to dissolve in water, and then the coagulation bath, it consists of aqueous NaOH, that is caustic soda solution, which will remove this water, that is solvent. And next, coming to polyacrylonitrile, which we are discussing about, we are taking dimethyl formaldehyde, and we are taking in combination of dimethyl chloride and then 60% zinc chloride, and the coagulation bath, it consists of these chemicals. Understand? So likewise, so depending upon the type of fiber and type of solvent we are taking, so where the coagulation bath recipes is going to be vary. So this is what we have to understand before start doing this filament production through this wet spinning process. Okay. Now you can see some of the parameters which has to be maintained in this wet spinning process, like the polymer and solvent we have to mix in a reaction vessel, and then filter, we have to remove the unwanted particles or physical impurities, and we have to degas also. And metering pump, which transfers a homogeneous solution to the spinneret with some pressure to the spinneret, and spinneret, it consists of 200 to 600 holes, which is having diameter of 0.005 to 0.025 centimeter. And the filaments from spinneret are coagulated in coagulation bar, which in the last slide also we have discussed what is the recipe to be maintained in coagulation bath. Okay, and if you want to increase the precipitation process, suppose in one bath if you are doing precipitation, if you are not expecting the removal of solvent, that is the solvent is not precipitated completely, we can increase the number of baths so that we can remove the solvent completely from the continuous filament of yarns. Okay, so this is all about the wet spinning process of making continuous filament of yarns. So, thanks for your listening. Okay, so till now, I'll just try to brief out what we have discussed till now. We have started discussing about solution spinning, what is solution spinning, and how in what way this is different from melt spinning process. And the melt spinning process is there with so many advantages, then why we are going for solution spinning. And solution spinning, how it has been categorized. So what is the category of wet spinning and how this dry spinning has been classified, and how to produce continuous filament of yarns through dry spinning as well as wet spinning process. Hope you understand this solution spinning concept well. Okay, in the next class, we will discuss in detail about the comparisons of dry spinning and wet spinning. Now we have discussed in brief in detail about each and every spinning separately. Now in the next class, we are going to discuss in detail about various differences from dry spinning and then wet spinning. Okay, so thank you all.